New power blocs are expected to emerge in the Senate with the election of 12 new lawmakers. How will the new composition of the upper chamber affect the workings of the incoming administration? And more than that, to weigh in on the Chief Justice issue, we are joined in the studio by Senator Francis Chiz Escudero, who's become very controversial lately. I've never met someone more controversial who isn't running. My gosh, my Twitter page is all about you.
Galit.
And you know what? Jen, you know, I'm very calm when I read Twitter. No, but I really want to ask you. I mean, you were very popular, and now with the Binay endorsement, you obviously have shown your mettle. But how is this affecting you, given the fact that Mars supporters are very emotional and affected?
That's understandable, Karen, kasi sa election, palagi namang emotional ang magkabilang kampo. Panalo man o talo, yung emotions palaging running high.
Mm-mm. Okay, but do you see yourself as causing the division between LP or the Noymar tandem?
I don't think so. Hindi naman sila kasal, hindi naman sila mag-asawang parang pinaghihiwalay. The Filipino voters and I also made a choice, and they didn't vote along party lines. They didn't vote along the tandems that the parties presented.
Okay.
Ganun naman talaga election.
All right, more questions for you here. I'll read about it later. Now, let's talk about this. No, this is very interesting. You're a member of the Judicial and Bar Council,
yes.
And can you tell us the process that went through it for President Arroyo to choose Justice Corona as the replacement?
The JBC, after the Supreme Court decision became final,
okay,
and was ordered by the Supreme Court to submit the list on or before May 17, complied with its mandate and complied with the order of the Supreme Court.
Okay.
We submitted the list Wednesday last week, in time for about a week or a week and a half before the retirement of Justice Ray Puno today.
Okay.
And then GMA, of course, as expected, exercised her power and appointed.
Mm-mm. Okay, do you agree that President Arroyo should have appointed Corona?
To begin with, Karen, I disagreed with the decision of the court.
Okay.
That this is not covered by the ban.
So, what do you mean? You disagreed with the Supreme Court?
Yes.
Agreeing to President Arroyo appointing?
Yes.
Okay.
And a lot of us also disagreed with it. But as an officer of the court, once a decision has become final and executory, we have no choice and we're obliged to follow it. The alternative, which is not to follow a decision of the court, would be anarchy. Ano yun, pag ayaw natin yung desisyon, di natin susundin. Pag gusto natin, dun lang natin susundin. Hindi ganun tumatakbo ang justisya at judiciary sa ating bansa.
Okay. Now, President-elect Senator Noynoy Aquino has already made calls for President Arroyo to, actually, it's in the papers right now, that she has a chance to actually change her mind.
I agree with Senator Aquino. She can, and I hope the President would heed the call of Senator Aquino, although I doubt it very much.
Okay, all right, but if and when Senator Aquino already takes his oath as President, is he mandated by law to take his oath in front of Chief Justice Corona?
I don't think it's a mandate of the law.
Okay.
But by tradition, all previous presidents took their oath, as far as I can recall, before the Chief Justice. But I'm not aware of any law that says that he should. In fact, a statement can be made by taking his oath before any officer authorized to administer oaths, including a barangay captain.
I heard that. Is that true that technically a president-elect can take his oath in front of a notary public? It wouldn't make a difference?
Yes, as long as the person is authorized to subscribe an oath.
I see. So even a mayor?
A mayor, barangay captain nga, pwede.
Pwede.
Ako, sa tatlong takbo ko sa congressman, I always took my oath before a barangay captain in our district.
Now, what would the effect be if Noynoy does this? Because he might. He just might. I mean, it's already leading to that. It says here that he plans to snub.
Legally, I don't think there will be any effect. But it would be a statement, and a good statement to make on his part, especially the position he took during the campaign.
All right. Okay. Now, we have Renato Corona coming in as Chief Justice. Given the fact that everyone in the Supreme Court are all Arroyo appointees, how do you see this affecting possible cases that will be filed against President Arroyo?
All except one, because there will be one vacancy after Justice Corona assumes the post of Chief Justice.
So how many will they be?
14.
14, okay.
14. I don't know. I'm hopeful that the Supreme Court will be independent-minded, and I'm hopeful that whatever people think or say about the justices of the Supreme Court, that they will have a sense of history and would abide by what the law states insofar as any cases brought before the court is concerned against JMA.
So President-elect Noynoy Aquino can appoint one justice to replace Corona?
Yes.
He can?
Immediately after he assumes.
Okay. Now, moving on to another topic, the Senate, for example. And there's a running joke that says this. It's actually all over Twitter. That imagine if Senator Noynoy gives his sauna, and then it's so funny. So, and then you have PGMA as House Speaker behind him, and then you have Senator Manny Villar as Senate President.
So the picture would be Senator Noynoy seated in the middle,
yeah,
with former President Arroyo to his left and Senate President Villar to his right.
Okay, no, but it looks like, let me ask you about President Arroyo. Last night, I from my sources, they tell me that she's not interested in the speakership anymore. Is that true?
As of last night, I think all they wanted is to have a big block, a minority block in the House of Representatives. But again, it can change. It's about a month and a half from the resumption of Congress. No, 2 months.
2 months.
And it can still change.
So do you think it'll be Mayor Belmonte who's coming in as congressman? There's a big chance.
Former Speaker Belmonte, he's a former speaker, has a good chance
of
getting it.
Now, let me ask you, how many liberals will be in the lower house?
It doesn't matter, Karen, because
it doesn't matter.
Even when Lacas won before, even when Arap won before in 98 or in 2004, there were very few PMP members at that time or Lacas members at that time. But as soon as the sitting president already assumed, members of Congress tend to gravitate towards the majority party.
I see. All right. Now, moving on to the Senate, do you think that Senator Villar still has the numbers to be Senate President?
He has a chance. He has the biggest block, I think, in the Senate, but not enough to make 13. So he has to enter into a coalition with other blocks or other groups in the Senate. But I don't know if he's interested, actually. To become Senate President again.
Actually, you know, I got a correction just now from our editorial head. Noynoy, Karen, is not yet President-elect. We can call him the emerging winner or the apparent winner. When is a person called President-elect formally?
Wala namang batas na ganun.
Wala rin. Okay.
Walang batas na ganun. If he's the clear winner, meaning he has been elected by our people but not yet proclaimed, technically he's President-elect. And clearly, given the margins, he has been elected by our people.
Okay. All right. Now, let's talk about going back to the Senate now. All right. So, given that Manny Villar has a bulk of the numbers, will his voting numbers affect him being Senate President? Because Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago said, given his showings in the polls, she feels he might not have that power in the Senate.
I don't know. All I know, Karen, is each senator is qualified to become Senate President and he has only one requirement to fulfill, 13 votes of his colleagues. And whether it's Senator Villar or any other senator, as long as he or she has 13, he or she will be the next Senate President.
Are you vying for the Senate presidency?
No, not at this time.
No?
Not at this time.
Why is that?
Wala lang, mas maganda yung payapang buhay.
Hindi naman mapayapa buhay.